video, I am discussing about octant rule in axial haloketo rule. Let us discuss about the octant rule. Octant rule was first formulated by Moffitt et al. For the correlation of the sign of Cotton effect of chiral cyclohexanone and its derivatives with their absolute configuration. Let us consider cyclohexanone. Molecular formula is CH2 5CO. It is a 6 carbon cyclic molecule with a ketone functional group. Here chair conformation is considered because chair conformation of cyclohexanone is more stable than boat form, because in chair conformation the CH bonds are equally axial and equatorial, that is out of 10 CH carbons the 5 are axial and 5 are equatorial, and each carbon is having one equatorial and one axial hydrogen. So that's why chair conformation is considered in octant rule. For the explanation of octant rule, chair conformation is considered. So this is a cyclohexanone in chair conformation. The space around the carbonyl group is divided into 8 sectors. That also known as octants, about x, y and z axis, with the help of 3 mutually perpendicular planes, plane A, plane B and plane C. So plane A is carbonyl oxygen and carbon 1 and 4. This is the carbonyl oxygen, carbon 1, and this is the carbon 4. So this is considered as plane A, and plane B is C double bond moiety and 2 attached carbons, that is C2 and C6, and plane C is intersects the C double bond at the midpoint. This is the plane C, from the midpoint of C double bond functional group. So plane B is perpendicular to, this is the plane B which is perpendicular to plane A, and plane C is perpendicular, this is perpendicular to both plane A and plane B. The two planes, plane A and plane B, thus divided the space around the carbonyl group into 4 coordinates designated as upper left, upper right, lower left and lower right, and the groups in these 4 quadrants will be contribute to the sign of the dispersion curve. That is, upper left is having positive sign, upper right is having negative sign, lower right is having positive sign and lower left is having negative sign. These 4 quadrants constitute the set of the rare octants. These 4 are known as rare octants, that is from the front view of the observer. On the left side of the plane C, which is not shown in the figure, there is another set of 4 quadrants which are mirror images of the former octants. The substituents lying in the front quadrant contribute opposite, that is the contribution of the sign of Cotton effect is exactly opposite to the back octants. The substituents in the vast majority of substituted cyclohexanones will appear only in the 4 rare octants. A part of some molecules appear in front coordinates, therefore for simple cyclohexanones plane C is ignored unless there are substituents in the left side of it only. The 4 rare octants defined by the plane A and B need to be considered. So every octant, these are the 4 octants and rare octants. So each is having axial and equatorial positions. So this is the rare octant view of the cyclohexanone. The sign of Cotton effect, upper left is given as positive, negative. This is given according to the following rules. So substituents lying in the coordinate plane A and B do not contribute much to the Cotton effect. That is 2E, that is equatorial position, 4A, 4E, 6E bonds. That is, see, 4A and E, because that is the, this if the molecules are having attached in this position, that does not show any Cotton effect. And 2E, this is a equatorial position, and 6E, these four planes does not contribute much to the Cotton effect. And the next one is, next rule is, substituents lying in the positive sector, that is upper left and lower right, make a positive contribution. And substituents lying in the positive sector, that is upper right and lower left, makes negative contribution to the Cotton effect. So this is the upper right and this is the upper left, which shows positive, negative, negative and positive. So positive Cotton effect is having axial and equatorial groups. In here axial and equatorial groups are there, which shows negative Cotton effect, and here only axial groups only, which shows positive Cotton effect, and here only axial groups, which shows negative Cotton effect. So consider the example. Here I am explaining the conformation of cis-10-methyl-2-declone. This is the 10-methyl-2-declone, which is cis conformation. This is the example conformation of trans-10-methyl-2-declone. These two are trans to each other. Thus, the absolute configuration of this enantiomer shows positive Cotton effect. Because consider this C double bond O has 2, this carbon is 3, 4, 5th carbon, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. In 10th position, methyl group is attached. So from here the observer can see, then we can write like this. This is the C double bond O group, this is attached to 3rd carbon, 3rd is attached to 4th carbon, 4th is 10th. 10 to 5, 6, 7, 8, which is attached to 9, and 9 is again attached to 1, and 1 is attached to C double bond O. In 10th position, methyl group is there. Methyl group is attached. So, this side of quadrant is given as a positive. This side is negative. Here positive and here negative. So all the groups attached here are in positive quadrant. So trans 10-methyl-2-declone is a showing positive Cotton effect. The other application for the octant rule is the conformation of 3-methylcyclohexanone. In 3rd position, methyl group is there. It is having R configuration, which is represented by 2 conformers. We can represent in this form or else in this form. So consider this one. First carbon is having the functional group 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In 3rd position, methyl group is attached. So if we draw this first carbon, which is attached to 6, 6 is attached to 5th carbon, then 4th carbon, then 3rd carbon, which is attached with methyl group and hydrogen, then 2nd carbon, which is attached to oxygen, that means the first carbon C double bond O. So methyl group is in positive side. This is the positive quadrant, negative, positive and negative. So this conformer shows a positive Cotton effect. Well, let us consider this one. This is showing negative Cotton effect because opposite to this one we are considering. So first carbon 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So similarly we are writing this one. First carbon is attached to 2nd carbon. 3rd carbon is having methyl group and hydrogen. Methyl group is in axial position and hydrogen in equatorial position, and attached to 4th carbon, 5th carbon and then 6th carbon. So this group is presented on negative side. So it is having negative Cotton effect. And the next topic is axial haloketo rule. The axial haloketo rule applies to cyclohexanones containing an axial halogen, that is chlorine, bromine or iodine, but not fluorine, next to the keto group. Why not fluorine? Because the polarizability of fluorine is low, while those of chlorine, bromine or iodine are higher compared to hydrogen. So that's why chlorine, bromine and or iodine is considered but not fluorine. So the axial haloketo rule states that the introduction of an equatorial hydrogen in either alpha position does not alter the sign of the Cotton effect of the halogen free ketone. Where the introduction of an axial halogen into alpha position may alter the size of cotton effect of the parent ketone. When this is a cyclohexanone with halogen which is in alpha position, functional group beside carbon is having alpha position, this is the beta position, we are taking alpha halogen. So the one who looking around looking from C double bond O axis as indicating in this figure like this, from if the observer is looking from this C double bond O group, if the halogen is on right side to this C double bond O, this halogen is in right side, there will be a positive cotton effect. If the halogen is on left side, that means like this, if the halogen is on left side, then we will get a negative cotton effect. If the halogen, alpha halogen, is on right side of the observer, then we will get a positive cotton effect. If the halogen is on left side of the observer, then we will get a negative cotton effect. Similarly, as a octane rule, we can write the similar way. C double bond O, carbon 1, which is attached to carbon 2, having the halogen, which is attached to C3, then C4, C5, C6, and C6 is again attached to C1 carbon. Positive, negative, positive, negative. So halogen is in the positive region. So it shows a positive cotton effect. Here also same, the halogen is in negative quadrant. So it shows negative cotton effect. So this is all about the axial haloketo rule, which is very important for MSc students. Thank you.